Alrighty, time for round one. I'm on the draw, and of course I have turn one Elves of Deep Shadow and a turn two, three drop. Probably gonna draw Dimir Aqueduct next, and it's just gonna be great. Though that Celestia Sanctuary was honestly not far behind. Turn two Centaur Safeguard. I could also play turn two Last Gasp into Sanctuary. That's not a terrible play if my opponent plays. Well, if they play a two drop, I just play a Centaur Safeguard. That'll trade for the two drop well enough, I would assume. No! I got punished for playing a turn on Elder Deep Shadow, Spark Mage Apprentice. Bzzzt. Alright, Dimir Signet? Dimir Signet would be nice. Island's decent. Alright, let's just play Celestia Sanctuary. I could have played Swamp and left up Last Gasp. I guess if my opponent plays a Sky Knight Legionnaire, the 2-2 Flying Haste, I will regret that. But if they don't, then I'd rather just play Centaur Safeguard and not cast Last Gasp on cards they were playing in the first couple turns here. Boros Signet into 2-drop. Thundersong Trumpeter. Tap target, you can attack or block. Fine card, fine card. Alright, let's play Centaur Safeguard. Don't particularly want to block Spark Mage Apprentice. This is just classic good control fun here. I've got Last Gasp, Faith's Fetters as removal, Dismisser once I hit 6, Consult to draw some more cards. Could also make my opponent discard depending on what they do. I'm only getting hit for one this turn, that is acceptable. Oh, attack them both. Alright, well, definitely block Thundersong Trumpeter, and if my opponent has a trick, they have a trick. Otherwise, I traded my 3-1 for their 2-1 with a great ability, and I gained 3 life. Okay. Boros Fury Shield, I guess, would be the trick that we'd be talking about here. I can live with that. So it prevents all the damage, and I take 3. I'm going to gain that 3 back, though. Yes, I would like to use that ability. Land. Now what? I think I'm actually just going to go Faith's Fetters on that thing. So the reason I'm doing that is I'm probably going to want to remove it at some point anyway. This makes it so it can't do anything, and I gain 4 life. This way, next turn, if I draw a black source, I can play Consult and Last Gasp on the same turn. Also, I kind of want to consult my opponent's last two cards. I don't want to consult them down to one card, though. That sounds a lot worse. They've missed a land drop, so if they go land creature, then I just get to consult their last two cards, and I have Dismiss or Last Gasp plus whatever they have, or against whatever they have, plus my draw step. Veteran Armor and Sellsword Brute. Okay. And Boros Garrison. Oh, that's a good land to draw. So now they have one card in hand. That makes me less excited to consult them. Ooh, much more excited just to play Vulture Zombie. All right. And I'm at 21. I can take some hits here. So now, if I play Zombie and it doesn't die immediately, then I'll get to use Last Gasp and Consult in order to get some value. I'm probably actually not consulting my opponent at this point, because they have a land plus whatever they drew this turn in hand, plus whatever they had last turn, and they're probably going to play one of those cards. It's unlikely that. And whatever they play is on 6 mana, so. It's unlikely that the last card in their hand is going to be something awesome. Whatever they play this turn is going to be the better card. Question is, do I block if they attack? Probably can. There aren't very many tricks that get me here, especially since any card going to the graveyard gets this plus one. So, like, Rally the Righteous gives all red or white, or, you know, is radiant, so it targets everything of the same colors. Plus two, plus zero, and untap your team. But if I block Spark Mage Apprentice and they rally, then it'll be a 3-2, and this will be a 4-4. So if they attack with just the 2-2s, I suppose I have to respect it and just take 4. Yeah, I'm fine with that. Because next turn I have Dismissor up, which could just make my opponent skip a turn. I also have Consult and/or Last Gasp. So, feels pretty good. Alright, opponent is sending everything. So, a 3 damage spell would already have killed Vulture Zombie. I think I can block Spark Mage, and I think that's safe. So, and there's a pretty big reward too. If I block and kill this, then the Vulture Zombie gets bigger. So, I have a pretty strong incentive. I mean, because I don't remember every trick exactly, but it seems like, all right. Yeah, that worked out just great. Could consult my opponent. Yeah, actually, kind of like that, now that they didn't play a card, because even if the cards aren't great, it makes my zombie a 6-6. Opponent's discarding now. Let's see what they got. And they did have rally. Ha! There we go. And yeah, I'm just going to smash for 6. I've got definitely what it takes to win the race here. My opponent has only one draw step because now they're going to hit me for 4. If they drew a card, they can play it, but I'm going to dismiss for them. And that's just going to be game. I guess I attack first, since it doesn't matter. I guess it's not literally game, but it's pretty close. Actually, it is game, because I can attack them down to 2 and then last gasp the Soul Sword Brute. And that will be that. Turns out Veteran Armorer. It's not going to defeat 6-6 Vulture Zombie. Boom. Alright. Playing against Boros. Peel gets a little better when they have cards like Rally in their deck. But I don't know that I necessarily want to add Peel here. I think we're good. All right. This hand's great if I draw a black source. Pretty medium if I don't. I'm in, though. All I need to do is draw Elves of Deep Shadow, and this hand just can't lose. Or Swamp. Swamp's also very good. With Swamp, I just get to play turn 3 Stinkweed Imp, turn 4 Moroi. The Moroi, the merrier. Boros Garrisons. My opponent was the recipient of these like incredibly late Boros Garrisons for reasons unbeknownst to me. I even have one on my sideboard. Ooh. Putrefy. This is just looking like a great draw. Stinkweed Imp's actually one of the most frustrating cards to play against, especially as an aggro deck. They just play the Stinkweed Imp and it's like, well, I can trade my creature for it, but you can just dredge it back. Oh, now I draw the Signet? How unlucky is that, honestly? Could have had a turn 3 Moroi. Though actually, it wouldn't even be that great. Moroi gets shut down by Thundersong Trumpeter and I lose a life per turn. This card very good too. 4-4 Flyer for 4. But does come with a cost. Biashino Fangtail. Don't love seeing that. So now what do I do? Thundersong Trumpeter is annoying. I think I'm just killing the Fangtail. I think it's just going to be more annoying to play against Fangtail like than Thundersong Trumpeter. Longer term. Next turn I can just play Woodwraith Corruptor, and then I can just start making forests into... wasn't attacking anyway, joke's on you. Then I can start making forests into 4/4s. Eventually I'll play a Moroi, but I'm not really looking to run that out against Trumpeter. It just feels like if things go wrong, I'd much rather not have Fangtail play. Like, if things go perfectly and I kill the Trumpeter and then play Moroi and start attacking them, yeah, that's great, but like a Boros Fury Shield or a Vase Fetters or anything, and, well, double Fangtail, that's pretty annoying. Speaking of Face Fighters, alright, let's play Woodwraith Corruptor. And pass the turn. And at some point, my best draw here? I guess it's Celestia Sanctuary is pretty good. Yeah, because that also let me activate Woodwraith Corruptor and make these into forests. I guess I can just use the forests. And then I can cast Faith Fetters. I suppose Celestia Signet's not the worst. Or just something like Compulsive Research, generally a good card. Any land lets me play Mora and activate Woodwraith Corruptor. I kind of want to activate Corruptor before I cast Dismissor. Dismissor is much more effective when you're attacking already. It's good when you're behind, too. It's also good at parity. Maybe the card's just good. this is a good position. I mean, any white land's great, because it just lets me cast Face Fetters, and I could use a lot of mana with Woodwraith out. Any non-white land is still okay, because I could, like, cast Mora and use Corruptor. And spells are fine. I can cast everything in my deck except this Face Fetters. So, overall, I think we're looking pretty good. All right. What are we dealing with here? At the beginning of your end step, sacrifice this creature unless it attacked this turn. Combo! Alright. It's a good way to kill a 3-6. It's pretty hard for a red-white to kill a 3-6. Screeching Griffin is good too. Right. Land. Yeah. Guess I'm in for playing Mora and using Woodwraith Corruptor. Alright, I suppose my opponent's going to use that as expected. And I suppose I don't attack with Stinkweed Imp. Yeah, make my opponent use double red if they want to make this get through. Alright. Did not expect my opponent to be able to kill my 3-6. That's good beats. You're going to shoot me for 1, too. Or shoot me for 1 as well. And now it's their 3 cards against my pair of 4-4s. I also have a Dismissor, which is not bad. Though now I'm in a position where drawing lands isn't very good. If I draw white-producing lands, that's fine. That's not bad. But drawing random blue, black, and green lands just doesn't do much for me. Last Gasp would be a good draw. Consult or Compulsive Research would be good. There's not a ton more that... I mean, I guess some of my... I don't have very many X1s. I have Elder Deep Shadow and Centaur 3-1, whatever it is. Centaur Safeguard. And those aren't particularly good against a Vishino Fangtail. Most of my random creatures are fine, though. Vulture Zombie would still be a great draw. Also, my opponent... can't play that many things that are gigantic, most likely. Like, if they draw Sellsword Brutes and whatnot, that's pretty good for me. Like, right now, if they have nothing to cast, I guess Screeching Griffin blanks my two attack blockers and it hits for 2. Go to 17, more I go to 16. Then in my turn, I just try to attack, only are able to attack for 4, and then I guess I dismiss the Thundersong Trumpeter so I can just keep attacking. I think that's the plan here. Alright, here comes Screeching Griffin. Mora and Stinkweed Imp. Yep. We'll take 2. I'm at 17. Now what? That is step 1. Nothing else. Interesting. Mora extracts its damage. That was unfortunate. I'm probably attacking the Stinkweed Imp now. Perhaps I should have attacked before. More I still can't attack. Opponent could trade off Fangtail for the forest. Guess I'm okay with that. And then what? And then I still think I dismissed the Thundersong Trumpeter. It feels like I'm winning the race at that point. Alright. And I guess I'm gonna keep the land in my hand in case I draw Compulsive Research. Especially given that I have Faith's Fetters. I mean, I can't cast it right now, but I have four sources to cast it. Given that I have Faith's Fetters, it feels like racing is decent for me, because I'm going to get to attack back for seven now. And I'm taking two plus one for my Moroi. So as long as I draw a spell or a white land, I'm in pretty good shape. I guess I'd rather draw a Signet or a Spectral Searchlight than an actual Sanctuary. Okay. Not the most aggressive card, but still okay. And play another Stinkweed Imp and pass the turn. So now we're racing my opponent's three against my four. Because I'm taking two from Griffin, one from Moray, and I'm hitting back with Dismissor and double Stinkweed Imp. Not the worst. Plus, my opponent at some point might forget to Stinkweed or Screeching Griffin my blocker. And I'll snap it off. Again, most of my deck is live right now. The fact that four of my mana sources are live helps. Though I guess two of those aren't actual lands, so I have a slightly higher normal mana source ratio, but still, I have a lot of live cards. That was definitely one of them. Alright. So we're gonna blank my Moroi. I'm gonna hit you for four. Signet. Faith's Fetters that. Now things are looking really good. Faith's Fetters is such a brutal card to race against. Because now I'm at 14, I'm very far away from dying, and then I have actual lethal out, so if my opponent doesn't have anything, Screeching Griffin has to like trade for a Dismissor or a Stinkweed Imp, at which point I'm just in incredibly good shape. Yeah, Celestia's Signet was... That or Spectral Searchlight were the white sources I wanted to draw. Celestia's Sanctuary would make things a little bit closer. Now I just straight up want to draw spells. And my opponent's been on that boat for many turns. They have 8 mana available, so they're hoping to draw spells too. And it doesn't look like they've actually drawn very many. They've gotten played 5 spells and 7 lands so far. And they've had 2 or 3 cards in their hand the whole time. Rally the Righteous is a pretty easy card to imagine them having. I guess it's fine to block here. If they have Rally, then I get to trade off anyway. There's no point in taking 2 damage. Four mana? Dogpile? That's not gonna do it. That does one for each attacking creature. Oh, I see, and then it kills the Moroi. Alright, my opponent did have some situational cards in hand. Dogpile is an especially brutal card when you're flooded. Alright. Now it's time to grind them out with Stinkweed Imps. Alright, play my land since I drew another one. Basically, just want to keep one land in hand for compulsive research. That's about it. We're both on a lot of lands, but my cards have traded for 2 things, like Woodwraith Corruptor, for example. Oof, Bottle Cluster. That'd make it hard for my opponent to win this game, even if they weren't dying to these motley crew of attackers. Alright. And play Bottle Cluster, because why not? And pass the turn. Things looking good here, given that I have 3 attackers, my opponent's at 2, and I'm drawing 2 cards a turn now. My only regret is that I won't really get to draw cards off Bottled Cloister. But what can you do? What can my opponent do to get back at this? I guess if they had a Faith's Fetters, they Faith's Fetters Dismissor, buy themselves a bunch of time. Otherwise, if it's just 1-for-1, I guess Lightning Helix does kind of the same thing. But it's pretty hard to stop 3 attackers when you're at 2 life. So I guess that's not going to happen. Given that my opponent said GG's, and we'll be on to round 2 shortly. And there we have it. Alrighty, let's see, I was going to draw Consult into Mark. Nice. Mm-hmm.